Example, a fun problem. A fan draws 1.42 meter cube per second of air at a static pressure of 2.54 cm of water through a duct 300 mm diameter and discharge it through a duct of 275 millimeter diameter. Question: determine the static fan efficiency if total fan mechanical efficiency is 70% and air is measured at 25 degrees Celsius and 760 millimeter mercury. Okay? Anong hinahanap natin? What is the required will be the static fan efficiency, which is the N is static fan efficiency. Okay, so that is the required. Then, the first one is 1.42 meter cube per second fan draws. So that is the capacity or the flow rate of the air, Q, equals 1.42 meter cube per second. At a static pressure of 2.54 centimeter of water, so that is the static pressure, that is 2.54 cm of H2O or water, and through a duct 300 mm diameter. So kung illustrate natin yan, so, ito yung fan. Okay, kung ito yung fan, ito yung fan. Okay. Draws meaning kumuha siya ng air. Okay, papunta dito yung air natin. Ito yung duct natin. Okay, air. And magdi-discharge siya sa kabilang duct. Circular duct na air. Yung fan. Okay, so the discharge is or the flow rate is same from the suction papunta sa discharge. Okay, same Q. Value ng Q. And then the static pressure is 2.54 of H2O. So that is the total static pressure. And then the diameter of the suction is 300 millimeter, and the diameter of the discharge is and discharges it through a duct of 275 mm diameter. So normally kailangan ang ginagawa dito is mas maliit talaga yung diameter ng discharge kaysa sa suction kahit sa pump. Okay, so next. So that are the given. So pinaka question natin, determine the static fan efficiency, which is ito kailangan natin. Ano bang formula natin ng static fan efficiency? Static fan efficiency is equal to air power static. Okay, air power static all over brake power. Okay, so we should get the brake power and the power air static power first. And another given is overall fan mechanical efficiency or fan efficiency, that is air power all over brake power. Okay, so this one is 70% given, di ba? And we can get up air power. And by using this formula, we can get the brake power. And that brake power will be used to get the static fan efficiency. Okay, so let's start to get the air power. Air power is equal to Q gamma H. Okay, so Q and gamma is both air to. So capacity of air, flow rate ng air, and specific weight ng air. Air times the head, total head. So total head, getting the total head will be static head plus velocity head, or kasama si friction kung meron mang given. For this example, wala tayong given. Okay, to get the static head, the static head is equal to head ng water times specific weight ng water all over specific weight ni air. Okay, so saan natin kukunin si head ni water? Kapag meron kayo nakitang given na static pressure, di ba? Ito na 2.54 cm of water, ito na yung head, static head ni water, yung 2.54 agad. So that is the HW. Okay? So wala namang given sa suction or sa discharge, isa lang yung given na static pressure. So 'yan lang gagamitin natin. Okay, 2.54 cm. So that is 2.54 cm, convert natin sa meter. That is 100 cm is 1 meter, di ba? Times specific weight ng water, which is constant na 9.81 kilonewton per meter cube. Okay? So ano ngayon yung specific weight ni air? Wala tayong given. Pero may given tayo na, anong given natin? Air is measured at 25 degrees Celsius and 760 mmHg. So therefore, we can get a specific weight ni air. So getting specific weight ni air, okay, ito natin kunin. Okay, specific weight ni air na may given air at temperature 25 degrees Celsius and pressure na 760 mmHg, or equivalent yan sa 101.325 kilopascal. Diba? Pag kinonvert mo yan, say, that is 760 mmHg is equal to 101.325 kilopascal or atmospheric. Okay? Equal yan. Pati 760 cancel. So, saan natin gagamitin yan? Paano natin makuha yung specific weight ni air? So, gagamitan natin siya ng favorite formula natin from thermo, di ba, na PV equals MRT. Okay? So, nasan dyan yung specific weight? Kukunin natin specific weight, bali, sa density. Kukuhain muna natin density. So, density is mass over volume. So, using PBMRT, mass over volume is equal to pressure over ideal gas constant times T, temperature, absolute temperature. So, the density will be, pressure is 101.325 kilopascal, or what is kilopascal? Kilonewton per meter squared, force over area, over ideal gas constant na 0.287 times times the temperature. Temperature is 25 degrees Celsius, but we should convert it to Kelvin, to absolute, plus 273 Kelvin. And what is the unit ng R natin? Ang unit ni R natin is kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Diba? Kung naalala. So, Kelvin, cancel. Then kilojoules is, what is kilojoules? Kilo Newton meter. Okay, so cancel si kilo Newton. Cancel din dya. And then si meter, pupunta dito yan. Magiging meter cube. And si kilogram, tataas. Kaya ang magiging unit natin dyan is kilogram per meter cube. So, to solve using calculator, syempre, ang density ng air natin is equal to 101.325 divided by 0.287 times 25 plus 273. That is 1.1847 kilogram per meter cube. And ayan yung density natin, but we need specific weight ni air. So specific weight ni air is just density ng air times g, or gravitational acceleration. So 1.1847 kilogram per meter cube times 9.81 meter per second squared. So cancel si meter, magiging squared to. Okay, sorry. Cube pa rin 'yan, 'di ba? Then meter to, kasi alam natin kilogram meter per second squared ay Newton. Tama? Newton 'yan. But we should convert that into kilonewton. That is 1000 Newton is 1 kilonewton. So kilonewton per meter cube ang specific weight ni air. Okay? So, answer will be 9.81 divided by 1000. So that is 0.01162 kilonewton per meter cube. So we can use that na to dito. So that is 0.01162 kilonewton meter cube. So cancel. So the static head efficiency natin, static head natin will be 2.54 times 9.81 divided by 0.01162. Then answer will be 100 pa. Gitin natin. 2.54 divided by 9.81 over 0.01162. Okay. 1162. Ngayon, naghihingal na yung kalkyo ko. Okay. So, ang sagot ay 21.44. 21.4435. meter. So that is the static head. And then to solve the velocity head, so that is velocity ng discharge squared minus velocity ng suction all over 2g. About wala pa tayong walang given na velocity, but meron tayong given na diameter ng discharge tsaka ng suction, which is ito 300 mm sa discharge and 275 sa suction, 300 to 75 sa discharge. So to get the velocity discharge and velocity ng suction, gagamitin natin si Q na formula na AV. QAV. So velocity ni discharge is equal yan sa Q over area ni discharge. Velocity ni suction is equal yan sa Q over area ni suction. So same lang sila ng capacity, which is yung Q. Which is Q is 1.42 meter cube per seconds all over area. So diameter yung given, meaning circular duct yung gamit dito. So parang ganito, diba? Diyan pumapasok yung air. Then may fan ka dito sa gitna. And binubugan niya yung air sa kabilang duct. Okay? So 1.42 area ng discharge, pi over 4 d squared, diba? So that is the area of circle. So that is diameter ng discharge is 275 mm or 0.275 meter. Okay? So kinonvert natin sa meter, dinivide sa 1000. So velocity ng suction same lang din, 42 meter cube per seconds all over pi over 4 times 0.3 meter naman kasi 300 mm yung given sa suction. So by solving both ng discharge and discharge and suction, so solve natin for Q. Okay, that is the velocity ng discharge. 6.5745. And velocity ni suction, palitan lang natin tong diameter na 0.3. Okay. 6.0267. So, anong unit natin dito? Squared pala to. Ulitin natin. Squared. 20 pala. Sorry. 20.0889. And this one. So, yan. Yan yung mga kailangan isiguraduhin para walang pagkakamali. Minsan, dyan sa pag-input sa calcu or sa area, may squared pala, hindi natin nalagay. Diba? So, that is 23.9074. Unit will be, yung meter squared dito, cancel na to, matitirang isa dyan. So, magiging meter per seconds. Meter per seconds, which is velocity unit. Okay? Okay, then, to solve the velocity head, sabi natin, discharge squared velocity, velocity suction squared over 2g. Okay? So, equals velocity ng discharge natin. Siyempre, mas malaki lagi yun. Yung 23.9074 meter per second squared minus 20.0889 meter per second squared all over 2g, 2 times 9.81 meter per second squared. So, magka-cancel si second squared dyan and si meter dito magka-cancel. Matitira meter na lang. Okay, which is yun ang unit dapat ng head natin. Okay, so by solving 23.9074 is to 2 minus 20.0889 raised to 2 over 2 times 9.81. Okay, double check lang muna yung input. So, kailangan natin double check yun lagi. So, ang velocity head natin will be, yun, 8.5627. Yan, meter. So, meron ka ng velocity head and static head. So, therefore, makukumpit na natin si air power, PA, na Q gamma ni air pareha times the total head, which is total head is HB plus HS. Okay, so air power will be Q ni air, given na kanina yan, di ba, 1.42 meter cube per seconds. Ang gamma ni A, or specific weight ni A, yung sinolve natin using yung given na pressure and temperature, that is 0.01162 kilonewton per meter cube. And yung H natin will be HS na 21.4435 plus yung HB na kasolve lang natin na 8.5627. Okay? So, the air power will be solving air power 1.42 times 0.01162 times 21.4435 plus 8.5627. So, ang answer natin for air power, total air power, is 0.4951. So, anong unit nito? Ito, meter to. Cancel si meter cube. Ang natira, kilonewton meter, which is kilojoules per seconds, kilojoules per seconds, or kilowatts. So, na kilowatts na si PA. And then, continue. Atin dito, ha. So, tayo mag-continue sa taas. Sulat ko lang ulit si PA na yung PA natin 0.4951 kilowatts. Okay? So, ito yung PA natin. So, ngayon, kanina may given tayong, sinabi ko sa inyo, ito, fan efficiency na 70%, tapos may PA na tayo, makukuha na natin si brake power. Then, pagkakuha na natin si brake power, ma-input na natin sa fan efficiency. So, total fan efficiency is 70% na equal sa PA over BP, brake power. So, brake power will be PA. Brake power is PA over NF, or fan efficiency. So, that is 0.4951 kilowatts over 0.07. So, brake power natin, or motor power na other term, is 0.4951 divided by 0.07. So, that is, 0.7 lang. That point, sorry. Kasi 70%, 0.7 lang. So, equals, yan, 0.7073. kilowatts. So, ito yung brake power natin. Siyempre, mas malaki yan kasi energy consuming yung mga compressor natin. Okay? So, to get the static fan efficiency, that is air power at static, okay, all over brake power. So, meron na tayo, yung static fan power, static fan power is Q gamma ni air times ni static head lang. Okay, which is na-solve na natin kanina ang static head, ito 21.4435. Hindi natin isasama si velocity head kapag kukumpitin natin si power static air power. Okay? So, over BP. So, diretso na natin. Capacity Q ni air is 1.42 meter cube per seconds times yung kinumpit nating specific weight ni air na 0.01162 kilonewton per meter cube and times HS na 21.4435 meter all over brake power. What is the brake power? 0.7073 kilowatts. So the static fan efficiency will be by solving ulit 1.42 times 0.01162 times 21.4435. Okay, that is in kilowatts na, divided by 0.7073. So 0.5002 times 100% para maging percentage ang fan static efficiency, that is 50.02%. So, pag may question or clarification dito sa video, you can comment. Okay? So, yan. Thank you.